The Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board begins hearing the fare hike petitions of transport groups. The transport sector has been seeking an increase in the minimum fare amid the spike in local pump prices. The group Pasang Masda is seeking a 5 pesos basic fare hike with an additional 1 peso per succeeding kilometer. Meanwhile, transport group LTOP is asking for a 2 peso increase.
Depende po doon sa mga questions po kasi na maitatanong at saka po sa mga sagot po ng ating mga petitioners po. So doon po tayo kukuha, ay doon po kukuha ng board ng mga tanong po. Nung huling board meeting po, ang napag-usapan po ng ating chairman po, si Chairman Guadis at saka po ng ating dalawang board member po, magdedepende po yan sa magiging resulta po ng pagdinig po mamaya. So titignan po natin kung ano po yung position po talaga, o kung ano yung ebidensya, o kaya kung ano man po yung maibigay po na preba na magko-convince po sa board na pagbibigyan yung kahit yung provisional increase.
With air travel almost back to pre-pandemic levels, stakeholders are now pushing for privatization to address issues hounding the Philippines' main gateway. Our very own Jackie Pascual with a full story.
Manila's main gateway rang in 2023 with a power issue affecting hundreds of flights and thousands of passengers. A few months later, Labor Day, another power outage hit the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. On top of those flight disruptions, issues with immigration officers, and recently the alleged stealing by airport screeners have seriously dented the image of the country's airport. At the 2023 Aviation Summit, many agree it's time to privatize NAIA operations, and most Philippine airports for that matter. One good model they see is the Mactan Cebu International Airport, which operates under a public-private partnership model since 2014.
We're looking at 24 more projects for privatizing the country. Luckily, had the experience of transitioning the first PPP project in Cebu Mactan. There have been a regional impact with our market reach.
Why airports are privatized, it's for sure most of the times it's the capex, the capital investment. Governments don't want, don't have, whatever the reason is, airport operators are doing that. The second is for sure we are generating new revenues, and the third, we are efficient, we are lowering the cost.
Tourism Secretary Cristina Garcia Frasco also wants the Cebu Airport model to be emulated.
The success of the PPP model in the Cebu Airport has the potential and should serve as the model for how airport operations are done across the country.
The Transportation Department earlier said that 6 firms have bought bid documents for the upgrade and operation of NAIA since the bidding was opened. But Senator Grace Poe, chairman of the Committee on Public Services, laments privatization efforts are taking too long to materialize.
1 year already has passed in the term of this current administration. And again, the OTR has come back to us and said that we have now changed it. We are not accepting unsolicited bids. We will change it now to solicited bids. We're changing the goalposts in the middle of the game, which is not what will make us enticing for investors.
Poe is also pushing for the establishment of the Philippine Airports Authority to operate and modernize airports, saying the Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines cannot be both the regulator and operator of airports. One thing all the attendees of the summit agree on, there really is a need to improve airport processes as demand for tourism is picking up following the pandemic. While stakeholders admit the industry is facing headwinds such as the lack of aircraft parts, the high cost of jet fuel, and a shortage of manpower in the aviation sector, they are all optimistic of the continued growth of air travel. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Another embarrassing incident at the NAIA involving an airport employee. Airport authorities have blacklisted a janitress for not turning in a lost phone owned by a passenger. Police were able to track the phone to the janitress's residence.
Yung pasero po, humingi ng tulong, rinipot sa airport police. Then, nung rinabaw na po ng ating kapulisan, ginamit yung iPhone locate yung iPhone apps niya, na-trace po sa isang barangay dyan sa Pasay. So initially po, parang dinideny po ata nung tao, but after ng thorough investigation na nasa kanya yung cellphone dahil hindi mapagkaila po na-locate doon sa tahanan niya yung location po, sir, gamit nga yung application na yon. So accordingly po, hindi na siya nakapag-deny. Binalik po, sir, yung cellphone ng ating pasero at tumingi ng tawad na ganun nga nagawa. Hindi na po nag-file ng kaso. Contractual employees, employees ng MIAA, and other concessionaire. Lahat pong nakikita nilang bagay na hindi sa kanila, especially lalo pag yung may mga gamit ng mga pasero, ay dapat po ito turn over yan. Mayroon po kaming lost and found section and unit.
It's the latest black eye for NAIA, where several cases of theft perpetrated by airport personnel have been recorded. A Singaporean mother and her daughter arrested at the Philippines' main gateway Thursday after being caught with around 76 million pesos worth of illegal drugs. Airport authorities say they found 14 kilograms of suspected cocaine hidden in the suspects' bags. The suspects claim they weren't aware they were carrying narcotics.
Mga goods, no, wherein talaga pong dyan po nila kinunsil, no, like yung mga cookies at yung mga tin can cookies at yung mga canister po, no, kung saan po ito po ay kilalang pa brand po wherein talaga pong sinil nila, no, and isa pang maganda, no, na ginawa nila, no, na para talaga makunsil ng maganda is they used a plastic po that would make it appear na binili ito sa duty free. Nakita po na imbis po na mga cookies at mga snacks, yung laman po ng mga tin can and canisters, cocaine po yung nakita po nila.
A book written by some of the best PR practitioners in the country has been launched, aiming to entice the next generation into the challenging yet rewarding world of public relations. Andy Ataguinas tells us more.
10 years since the birth of the PR Matters weekly column comes a compilation featuring the best of the best in one book. Penned by the brightest minds in the public relations industry, it tackles a range of topics from PR basics and project management to corporate social responsibility and ethics. The Philippine chapter of the International Public Relations Association hopes the book would serve as a guide to doing good and honest PR work and to promote PR as a viable career option for the next generation.
For those who are considering, should I go into communication or PR? Well, this book maybe will help you understand what it takes to be one. In PR, we always want to do what we do best because we want to do PR for good. Kung paano po maging mas maganda yung buhay ng mas nakararami.
Some people think that PR is simply helping to position a person or a brand. We talk about PR as doing good and telling people about it. So that's something that's important, that it cannot be posturing all. It has to be true, it has to be effective, and it ideally should be impactful for the communities that you operate in.
Nieva notes, even non-PR practitioners can learn a thing or two about being a better communicator, whether those who are in government.
During my term as DOT Secretary, clear and effective communication was critical due to the ever-changing health and safety protocols that kind of changed every day, travel restrictions, tourism destination openings, financial aid, and vaccine distribution.
Or in news.
Whether I'm sharing a heartwarming human interest story or the latest political or economic developments, my goal is the same: to convey a narrative that resonates, that motivates, and that sticks in the minds of our viewers long after the broadcast ends. Because much like you guys in the realm of public relations, I understand that people don't just remember facts, they remember stories.
For Business Mirror Editor-in-Chief Lourdes Fernandez, the write-ups can also be a source of comfort and hope like how the coronavirus chronicles were to her and their readers at the height of the COVID-19 pandemic. These will also be featured in the book.
They were honest enough to talk about how they were experimenting, how they were coping, how they were dealing with the mass anxiety of their people, of their sectors, of their stakeholders, even as I knew they were deep inside, all of them were sharing our collective fear, our uncertainties.
The PR Matters book is now available for pre-order. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
And let's get an update now on the weather from ABS-CBN resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas. Ariel, over to you.
Hi, good afternoon, Carmina. More areas in the country are expecting to get sunny and warm conditions, but rains are still also expected later today. The low-pressure area over the northern Philippine Sea has dissipated, said Pag-asa. The southwest monsoon or habagat prevails and brings scattered rains over Mimaropa, western Visayas, and Zamboanga Peninsula. In the coming hours, intense thunderstorms are forecast in La Union, Pangasinan, Central Luzon, Calabarzon, northern Mindanao, Caraga, and Sokcharjen. Meanwhile, a low-pressure area outside of the country is also being monitored. At 10 this morning, it was located 2,110 kilometers east of southern Luzon. This weather disturbance may enter the PAR as a tropical depression by Saturday. For now, it is not seen to move close to or make landfall over any part of the country. However, it may enhance the habagat, which may bring rains over the central and southern parts of the archipelago this weekend. The next storm name is Jenny. And here in Metro Manila, it will remain sunny and hot until this afternoon, and an intense thunderstorm is again forecast between late afternoon and early evening. That's the latest on the weather. Back to you, Carmina.
Ariel, talk to us about the thunderstorms that we've been seeing past couple of days. What's causing that?
Yes, so for now, the habagat is not affecting Metro Manila. However, what happens is that during the day, at least until the afternoon, because of the warm weather, there is much evaporation and there is lots of moisture available around the Metro Manila area. So these then turns into thunderstorms, which are very intense and happen during nighttime. Now, with the flooding, there may be some issues with waterways obstructions as well as poor trash management in those areas, especially along EDSA, in Araneta Avenue. So these are the things that may be needing to be looked into.
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. Ariel Rojas there joining us on the line.